Welcome back, fellow scientists. It's Justin again. What? Oh, no, I feel fine. I was just doing my robot impression to prepare for today's episode of Science in the Real World. By the end of... Sorry, once I get started, it's hard to stop. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to identify the basic functions of robots and describe their history, types, and applications. Let's get into it. In this unit, we learned about how we use electricity to power our world, channeling it through circuits to power our homes and devices. The knowledge we gain as we continue to study electrical energy and circuitry allows us to explore new horizons of technology, like robotics. The use of robots is growing rapidly. You might already have a few in your own life. But what exactly is a robot? Think of the robots you've seen in movies, TV, or real life, and record your thoughts in your guided notes. I've seen robots that look and act a lot like humans, but I've also seen some that look totally different. I've seen robots that walk on legs and robots that suck up dirt off the floor. With all these differences, what exactly makes them all robots? Robots are the ultimate helpers. A robot is a machine that can be programmed to complete a task automatically. They can perform tasks that are too difficult, dangerous, or downright boring for humans. So instead of a human vacuuming the floor, a robot does it. Instead of a human building objects on an assembly line, a robot does it. Robots can be a little tricky to define because for a long time, they were more of a dream than a reality. For example, ancient Greek mythology featured tales of mechanical beings like Talos, a giant man made of bronze who protected the people. In the 1400s, artist and inventor Leonardo da Vinci drew up designs for a mechanical knight. With the pull of a string, the knight could sit, wave its arms, and move its head and jaw, showing early interest in creating machines that mimic human actions. The word robot wasn't actually used until the year 1920. In a play titled Rossum's Universal Robots. In this play, robots were artificial people created to work for humans. The real breakthrough in robotics came with the rise of computer technology in the mid-1900s. As computers advanced, so did robotics, leading to the sophisticated machines we have today, used in industries from manufacturing to space exploration. Robots today are nearly as diverse as the people who build them. They can be classified into different categories based on their functions. What different types of robots can you think of? One category includes industrial robots. These robots are used in factories and manufacturing plants. They can perform repetitive tasks, like assembling products, or tasks that would be dangerous for humans, like handling hot metal parts. Service robots are designed to assist humans in tasks like cleaning, delivering goods, and providing customer service. Robotic vacuums and drones that deliver packages are service robots. Robotics have gotten so advanced that they can even be used in hospitals. Medical robots are used in healthcare settings for surgeries, diagnostics, and rehabilitation. Robots such as the Da Vinci robotic surgical system can perform surgeries that require extreme precision, such as repairing heart valves, which can be challenging for even the most experienced doctors. And of course, there are entertainment robots as well, created for fun and education, such as robotic toys, animatronics, and robots used in theme parks. Each category of robots has specific features and uses, showcasing the widespread usefulness of robotics in our world. As we look to the future, the potential for robotics is hugely exciting. Advancements in artificial intelligence, or AI, are making robots smarter and more autonomous. This means they can learn from their environments, adapt to new situations, and perform tasks without constant human supervision. Imagine a robot that can clean your house, cook your meals, and even fold your laundry, all without you providing instructions. In healthcare, robots are expected to become even more helpful, with advancements like robotic exoskeletons helping people with mobility issues walk again. These wearable robots can provide support and strength to those who need it, changing the way we approach physical therapy and rehabilitation. Robots will also play a crucial role in the future of space exploration. Future missions to Mars and beyond will rely on advanced robotic systems to explore and gather data in environments that are too harsh for humans. These robots will be our eyes and hands on distant planets, paving the way for human exploration. The future of robotics is not just about creating machines that can do more. It's about enhancing human life and solving some of the world's biggest challenges. As scientists continue to push the boundaries of what robots can do, the possibilities are endless. What would you like a robot to help you with? Who knows? Maybe one day you'll be designing the next generation of robots. But until then, let's review everything we've learned today. Robots are machines that can be programmed to complete a task automatically. There's a large variety of robots, each helping humans in unique ways. Robots are expected to play a big role in future innovations, including AI, healthcare, and space travel. To review everything we've learned in this unit, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. Great job learning today, scientist. What, you don't like my impression, Mia? You're right, robots are so advanced these days that my impression is a little outdated. Maybe I'll just leave the robot speech to you. Remember, scientists, curiosity is the architect of discovery. See you next time! Hey.